Hello, Grad Nines. It's Mrs. Cater once again. We will quickly talk about the extract or the short drama on page 176 in your textbooks. So let's see what's happening here. First of all, Grad Nines, you need to understand what the purpose is of a drama. A drama is the opvoering van 'n story met die doel om geniet te word. So you have to enjoy this little drama, the play, what they are busy trying to explain or show you. When we look at a drama text, the whole text actually comes to its right when you look at the actors, die regisseur, die verhoogbestuurder, you know, the stage manager, die beligtingspan or the sound system team, usually the lights and the sound systems in these days, they are one team. The set, die kostuumontwerpers, you know, all those makeup artists, everybody. They cooperate together to set up a very good drama or play for you. So, when we are going to read this drama, we're going to pay attention to the dialogue. We're going to pay attention to beeldspraak, where we have vergelykings. You know it better in English as a simile, a metaphor, en personificatie, metaphor, and personification. There's always a theme and a message. Daar's altyd 'n tema en 'n boodskap in 'n drama. And of course, we have characters. Main characters, of newe karakters, or sub-characters, however you want to explain it. Then, the ruimte, the background where the scene is playing off, the handeling is the action that's going to take place, and then your stage and the acting, die toneelaanwysings, die verhoog en toneelaanwysings. Dis 'n woorde wat jy baie mooi moet leer of van graad 9 af, want in graad 10 gaan jy baie daarna verwys of moet verstaan. En dan natuurlik die tyd, né? The time. In which time of the day or night does this play happens? So, die kenmerke van hierdie drama wat ons nou gaan lees, in die eerste plek gaan ons agterkom dat the setting, the place, is a modern lounge or sitkamer, moderne sitkamer in 'n huis. Dan die tyd is unknown. We don't know when it happens, but maybe it's after school, because you know two teenagers usually sit and visit en kuier nou lekker na skool by mekaar. Dan die gebeure, the actions, what happened actually in this drama. Nou mense, dit is twee tieners wat gesels oor die dringendheid dat die aarde beskerm moet word. So you will hear about two teenagers that's going to chat about the importance of saving the earth. Nou die een karakter is Peter. Dis vir hom belangrik, maar vir Sarah is dit nie so erg nie. Sy dink dis nie so groot probleem nie. So ons karakters het ek nou vir jou verduidelik, is Pieter, 13 jaar oud, hy dra 'n bril and he has a laptop always with him. So it seems like this Pieter loves to do some research and read up about some things. Dan het ons vir Sarah, en Sarah is boeiems met oorfone om die nek. Nou ok, op hierdie prentjie kon jy vir nou nie oorfone om die nek kry nie, maar boeiems beteken, sy is different. Sy hou daarvan om bietjie anders te wees, soos jy nou kan sien hierso, sy's a beautiful girl, but the hair looks different, and she is easy way, easy go. That's how Sarah is. So, as I said to you, the place, the setting where this drama plays off is in the book they refer to a hypermoderne sitkamer. So it's a very, very, very modern sitting room. So then it gives us also some idea about our two teenagers, that they are used to luxuries. They are used to the lekker things in life, no? So we know the place is a very modern lounge or sitkamer. Die tyd is nou vir ons onbekend en ons weet het is nou twee teenagers wat nou gaan gesels oor die dringendheid om die aarde te beskerm. Vir die een is dit belangrik en vir die een is dit nie belangrik nie. So nou gaan ons lees. The title, Die Aarde Weet, like the Earth Know. Now people, Earth, it's a planet. It's not a human who can know. Weet means know, like knowledge. Nou, hoe kan die aarde weet? So immediately we see in this title, we get the metaphor. The whole play is based on a metaphor. You will hear when he starts talking about how you can save the earth. He tries to make a point at Sarah, how Peter is referring to earth. Maar die woorde, die aarde weet, is actually personificatie. Because we take a human thing, a menselijke eigenskap, and we give it to the earth. And that's impossible. That's why we call it personificatie. So, met ons toneel, en hier is nou die toneelaanwijsings, wat beteken, jy kry nou extra information, waar speel jou toneel af, en wat gebeur. So they tell us, it's two teenagers, hulle sit lay, so they do not sit straight up, they sit lying, lekker gemakkelijk, na? And they chat about a lot of things in a very modern lounge. The characters, one is Peter, the boy of about 13 years old, he is lying on a couch, and he is busy looking at something on his laptop, and he also wear glasses. So he's a bit nerdy, maybe, now. And Sarah, she is boeiems, she's different, she has earphones around her neck, and she seems that she's a bit bored. Something bored. Okay. So now, you must keep in mind that this toneel aanwijsings have a function. And that is to tell us where the place is, the setting of where this play is going to play. Or where the play is going to happen. Right, now we're gonna read. Peter Senna. Ons het vandag in die klas geleer hoe sag dit eindelijk met ons planeet gaan. Ons sal iets moet begin doen om die aarde te red. So he's saying, in the class today, they studied or the teacher teach them about how bad it actually went with planet Earth. So we can make the conclusion that maybe they talk here about global warming, ne? And now he said, we must start doing something to save the Earth. And now, what's Sarah's reaction? Sarah said, ach, wat is nou so erg? Allemaal herwin of her iets. So she's saying here that, what's so heavy about this? Everybody is busy to recycle something or re-something. Okay, so she's a bit, don't care. Now, and then Peter said, dit is seker so, maar verbeel jou, jy sit op 'n groot, gemakkelike reddingsvlot. So Peter said, jou, what if you are sitting here on a lekker big, very easy safety raft. You know, that thingy where they put the poles together and bind it with a rope to keep it together. Something big like that. Now he's saying, this is not just a normal raft. Jy's bezig om 'n boek te lees of om na jou iPod te luister. En op die reddingsvlot, om de safety raft, is alles wat je nodig hebt: kos, water en skuilplek. So of course you have your water, your food and a place where you can sleep. So all the things that human beings need, né? That is essential for our human beings. Then Sarah said, okay, but what about electricity? Wat van krag? So Pieter sê toe vir haar, hy antwoord dat en hy sê toe, daar's 'n energiebron, 'n energy thing what you can use to make food, to warm up water, so that you can bath, a lekker luxury bath, lig, to get the light in the evening when it is dark, en om, listen to this, en om jou PlayStation of jou Xbox of wat ook al te laat werk. Now people, can you imagine your PlayStation Xbox on a raft? Sarah said, is daar enige iemand saam met my op hierdie reddingsvlot? She wants to know if there's anybody else with her on this safety raft. And Pieter said, yeah, of course, remember, your friends, your family, your dog, even your pet, na? En dit is, sê hy, to be the truth, to be honest, a baie luxe reddingsvlot. He said, to be honest, it's a very luxury safety raft. Okay, so now Sarah is, okay, now she said to him, okay, dit klink lekker, waarna toe gaan ons? So she said, it sounds nice, waarna toe gaan ons? So Sarah thinks like you are on a nice boat with all the luxuries, you have everything with you, and you are traveling from the one country maybe to another country. That's how Sarah is thinking. Listen what Pieter said. Hy sê, die probleem is, there's the problem. Daar is nêrens om hierheen te gaan. There's nowhere, no place to go to. Okay, now we wonder. Sarah asked, gaan dit vir ewig aanhou? Will it hold on forever? So Sarah is nou a bit confused. Nou sê Pieter, aha, dit is waar die sporks begin. Okay, he said, yeah, this is where the thing starts happening now. Ongelukkig ontwikkel die reddingsvlot 'n paar probleme. So he said, unfortunately, our safety raft is developed some problems. Nou werd dit nie meer so lekker nie. En stukke daarvan is besig om af te val. Dit moet reggemaak word, dit kan sink, en wat word dan van jou? So, people, just like when you are on a boat, if you don't look after your boat and you keep it into a good condition all the way, it's going to break. And then, if it breaks, it gets holes in. If there's holes, the water will come through and then it will sink. And what will happen with you? You will most probably drown when you are in the middle of the sea. Okay. And here is actually what Pieter is trying to make his point. Because here he compares the earth with this safety raft. The earth is our safety raft. And if we do not look after our safety raft like a boat, we are going to lose it. Okay? But Sarah still don't understand. So, now. Sarah said, ek bel iemand om te kom help. Easy. She will find someone to come and help her. Na? Pieter sê toe, jy het vergeet. You forgot. Jou reddingsboot is die enigste een op die oseaan. So you have only that safety raft on the ocean. Daar's niemand om jou te help nie. En jy moet dit self doen. Want dis jou reddingsvlot. En dis die enigste een wat daar is. So actually, yeah, Pieter wants to tell Sarah, remember, the Earth is actually our only planet where we can live on. Yeah, there's a lot of people that did research in space and they talk about live on the moon and Mars or whatsoever. But no one else can come and help us to save Earth if we do not start to do something self. Because it's our Earth, it's our safety raft, and that's the only Earth in this whole world, in this whole space. It's only Earth. And we have to look after this Earth. En dis waar Sarah nou sê, ach nee man Pieter, dit is een onrealistische situasie. So Sarah immediately thinks, it's unrealistic, it does not make sense to her. And Pieter sê to her, think very carefully, denk mooi. Is dit regtig? He asked, is it really that unrealistic? And now he said, wat as ek, jy kies her the answer, he helps her into the light so that she can understand. Wat as ek sê die reddingsvloot, the safety raft, is the order, is Earth, die enigste een wat ons het, the only Earth what we have. And immediately, Sarah, remember, jo, okay, jy wen, dit is een hengse probleem, kom ons denk aan oplossings. So Sarah realized, it's a problem. If we don't look after Earth, we will have some problems. And that is the point in this drama. Only two friends, they sit and chat about how to save Earth, and it's actually very nice, and it's actually very clever of Pieter to use the Earth as a safety raft so that people can try to compare or understand. Now let's check at the theme of this drama. Now people, the theme is that all of us, ons allemaal, het a responsibility, het a verantwoordelijkheid om die aarde te beskerm. All of us must look after the earth. We have to try to prevent pollution. We have to try to look after our nature, plant trees, and really look after what we are doing in the fabrics or what we do in the mines and stuff like that. So, now the question's very short. They ask you here, kies die regte woord tussen hakies. And then they said, die reddingsvloot word gelijkgestel. Now, gelijkgestel means they equals it. Okay. So, man just explained to you, this whole story is actually the metaphor about they use the safety raft and compare it, equals it with the earth. So, the reddingsvloot word gelijkgestel aan die aarde. En dis een metafoor. Hulle sê nie vir ons, die reddingsvloot is soos die aarde nie. As daar die woordkie soos in is, dan is dit 'n vergelyking, 'n simile. Maar metafoor is waar jy eienskappe van twee goed met mekaar in verband bring. So you bring two things, some things about the one thing like saving raft and what must be saved, the earth. If you don't look after your saving raft, you will drown. If we don't look after earth, we will regret it. Question number 2. Wat sou jy sê is die drie belangrikste dinge wat op die reddingsvloot is? Motiveer jou antwoord. If you should choose the most three important things on the safety raft, what would you say is it? Okay, ma'am said, 'n energiebron, because we want some electricity, we need food, we need water, and we need a scale plaque of a house. You could only say, because they ask three things. You could only say food, water, and a place to sleep, like a home. Ma'am said, yo, what about energy as well? We need a bit of sunlight, hey? Imagine life without sun. Dan, to motivate further, hierdie drie goed, dit is wat jy nodig het om te oorleef. People, you can't actually live without it. You can't live without the sun. You can't live without food. You can't live without water. And definitely, you need a place to stay in, to keep away from cold, or rain, or wind, or stuff like that. Onthou, juffrou het gesê, energiebron, dit is die son. That's why ma'am say that's important. Nommer 3. Wat lei jy uit die teks af, beteken die woord Leekse. Now remember, ma'am, give you the explanation that leekse refer to luxury. But if we have to answer in context with the text, with this drama, it is everything what you need and more. Everything what you need and more. Like, I need my iPad, but I need also my laptop. But I need also electricity so that it can work and so that I can charge it when the batteries went flat. That is what a luxury is. Number 4. Wat is fout met die reddingsvlot? Now remember, this reddingsvlot, this safety raft they refer to, is now Earth, ne? So what's wrong with it? Die reddingsvlot is verwaarloos. We neglected it. And it is besig, dis besig om te breek. Ons kyk nie na dit nie, en die aarde is besig om vir ons te wys met die global warming, something is busy to go wrong. Nommer 5. Gaan dit makkelijk wees? Will it be easy om die reddingsvlot te laat regmaak? Now remember, this reddingsvlot is Earth. Will it be easy to fix the Earth, people? Motivate your answer. Definitely no. It's not going to be easy. Because the eienaar, the owner, which is us, our humans, van die reddingsvlot, sal alles self moet regmaak. We have to fix everything. We must decide that money is not everything, so stop mining and do water pollution. Money is not everything, so stop do air pollution. We have to look after our earth. We are the owners. There's no one else that can help us. It's only our human beings that must come to that conclusion and realize we need to do something now. Then, number 6, wie sal moet help om die reddingsvlot reg te maak? As dit net ons is, wie anders? Almal wat op die reddingsvlot woon. This question, you can actually put it like this, wie sal moet help om die aarde reg te maak? Everybody on earth, everybody that stays on earth must do their duty and they have to help so that the earth can stay healthy and that we make sure that we will live here for many years. Then number 7, wat is die tema of boodskap van hierdie drama? As ma'am explained to you, all of us has a responsibility to look after the earth. Almal van ons het 'n verantwoordelikheid om die aarde te beskerm. Vraagie 8, hoe verskil die twee karakters so op opinie ten opsigte van die toestand van die aarde? So remember, our two characters, Peter and Sarah, they differ in opinion about the stage where the earth is in. They differ about the stage. How does it differ? So first you're going to say, Peter besef the importance that the earth must get the necessary help and hy moet beskerm word, en Sarah dink dat the situation is not that bad. Sarah thinks it's, die situasie is nog nie so erg. And then the last question. Hoe word daar spanning in die drama verkry? Now people, sometimes in every drama, they try to get some tense. How did I try to put tense in this drama? And ma'am didn't explain it to you earlier because I want to explain it now when we address the question. Remember, Peter described how bad the situation is. And then on the end, Sarah realized that there is something wrong and they have to do immediately something to the problem. And that is how they put tense in the situation. It's young people, so now they realize if other people do recycle, it's not to say that we are not supposed to help, or we have to plant trees, or have to keep our rivers clean and stuff like that. So that is how they try to put a bit of tense in this drama. I hope you understand and that everything is fine. Not that difficult. It's a very nice drama and a lekker discussion between two friends. Keep well.